hold 2 seconds on it. What's this place called?
Bethel Quarry.
Bethel.
Yep. It's all quite clean as well, all the walls.
There's a bit of clean, doesn't it?
You know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of something out of a Bond film. It's that big for it.
Yeah.
You have the fucking.
Yeah. Plus, it's just a little ring, right? It's more cold than it is.
You won't get lost in this place. It's like it wibbles and wobbles, but there's one way up and one way down. You know, there's a couple of ways it splits off into two tunnels going up and two tunnels going down, but yeah.
Pretty solid stuff, isn't it?
I can't really see any rock falls and stuff that's happened in ages. I mean, it was very old.
Yeah.
We'll go back round.
What's the matter?
I don't know, I think it's just them playing around, like, you know. I mean, it could be, because if you look, there's a split behind it.
Yeah.
So it could be to hold that split from moving.
Shame the lights aren't
on. Oh, yeah. I guess this is basically the upper end of the cave. So there ain't much more now. This is just the old original cave tunnels, and there ain't much in there. And you can tell we're at the top because we're walking uphill.
Yeah.
So this is basically the end of it. Good little idea, really, because all the water runs down and would come out of the main entrance and just go straight into the canal.
Yeah.
But this is the tip of the iceberg, because it's quite big. So he's going to sit up there now on his own board.
He might be fixing his car, I don't know.
Ah, yeah. Oh, I think we had a bat then. Well, I reckon it must have been like 1900s up to 1980, you know, being driven along by JCB type vehicles, you know, and all that sort of stuff. So this is where it all starts to get a bit more interesting now, because you've got evidence of this. He's gone, isn't he?
I think he's gone, yeah.
Lithium batteries, says somebody's pissed off the fucking lithium stopped working. So there's various ways you can get down. Tell you what this would make, actually, this place, would be excellent for cheese storage. Yeah. Because it's naturally cold, so you don't have all the bills for the electric to keep stuff cold. And all the roads are basically in here. So, I mean, for cheese storage, you'd just be running in and out with trolleys all day long. Smoke though, innit?
Yeah.
You'd have to get the air filtration working quite well for that. But I reckon they'd be minted if they wouldn't have to do that much conversion work in here for like a cheese factory. Place like that, they don't go that far, little deads. Sometimes they block areas like this off because they consider these ceilings a bit risky. Sorry. It's usually like the cold is good for my hay fever and stuff. There you go. Evidence of like living quarters and stuff. I was only drinking water, one was on the right.
How important that there is, resuscitation.
Yep. Storerooms. God, every couple of seconds my nose is like, it just refills. Bollocks. This is their like mess room, you know, for changing clothes and maybe eating food and stuff. Here's your sleep air tonight, love. Sleep on a mattress tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Quality.
She really got Dave, and we've been messing up, haven't we? Getting down on that mattress.
Oh my god. Yeah, wherever we go, there seems to be a bloody Christmas tree.
Yeah.
Everywhere we go, there's a bloody Christmas tree. So there's changing rooms in that room.
I think it might have been by the looks, isn't it? Just get a stack of people in here. Probably could heat somewhere like this as well, like having a bit more comfortable.
God, but the smell was horrendous once you finished working. And get off a bit, like dropping.
Mushroom pests and diseases.
Tom,
sorry,
we've got a mattress in one room,
a
swimming pool in this room.
Yeah. Well, the swimming pool was probably to keep the water in to feed downhill through pipes to all the grow rooms. So they put it up here so they got like a head of water. And all these numbers for the for work they were up to grab a number, like, you know.
Nice.
Yeah, that probably was for the cannabis.
What's all these numbers for?
I don't know. Maybe like grab a number, stick it on your vehicle or your trolley or on your mushroom pack that you're grabbing.
What's that smell? You can still like smell it. Fungal.
There's all sorts of crap down here as well, like, you know, where people have been throwing stuff and smacking stuff around. When you see the grow rooms, you'll find it quite funny.
Is this why it still works?
That's good.
It's been smashed off, is it?
Yeah, it's not even, the needle's not even moving.
Try and spin the needle back a bit.
I haven't even touched the torch.
That spring was making a sound like somebody's phone was just starting to play Eye of the Tiger or something. It was like, jong, jong, jong,
my torch just started flashing. I haven't even touched
it. Ooh, ghosties.
Okay.
It's the ghost of mushrooms past. I think a lot of these were mushroom related.
They don't make it, don't they?
Yeah. And these trolleys and things. I mean, it's hard to think that people would have been like wheeling trolleys of mushrooms up and down here by hand, but they might have been. That's obviously a grow thing off a cannabis plant.
Yes.
So, the nice spores there on that over there. Now, somebody told me, that does look like spores and that looks like growth, but somebody told me that this weird stuff that looks like fuzz, they said it's not organic. They said it's like bismuth or something. It's like it comes through the air and it drops out of the air and it forms into like pockets, yeah.
Looks like snow a bit, doesn't it?
But it looks like it's organic and people are like, oh, spores, but apparently it's not. If that's the same stuff I've been told, it's actually a chemical. like a compound.
Yeah.
When we first came in here, there were bits of greenery still on some of them, but I think it's gone now. You can still smell a lot of it if you grab
it.
There's
a few leaves there still.
Mm.
So that's the marijuana.
That's where they, when they've grown the marijuana and they've they've used all the energy in the earth. They just dump the earth, go get a new load of earth, and then plant another plant in it.
That's mad, that,
You see that in a lot, because I've been to more than one cannabis place that's been busted now. And you do this, they chuck a lot of that.
They had that really big one up this way, didn't they?
Chillmark.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, guess what the police said about this? They said, we've busted this place, and we've taken out everything we can, but we're not sure if we've got everything, because the place is so big we got lost. That's what they said about this place.
Well, don't you get the blueprints?
Don't know. It's like land that time forgot down here, isn't it? Now watch these things, because you might trip over on these. They're a bit dangerous.
So, that's
yeah, watch them. You can go flying on these. Well, here we go then. Grow rooms.
Wow, that's huge. Holy. Whoa. Oh, they are just slippery, isn't
they? Whoa.
And then you go into the silver grow rooms. I think people have been down here stealing these. Because
they're worth a lot of money.
They are worth, and the thing is, you see, all you have to do is where the police slashed them with knives, that's the police did that, they just slash, slash, slash. All you've got to do is stick tape across that, and you've got to, it just does the same job.
You can even buy foil tape, can't you?
You could repair it with some tape, yeah.
Wow.
But all this is all serviceable, it's all usable. Probably a grand's worth of tent there, probably, I would imagine. Oh, this has fallen down.
Still got a fan here,
that. Mmm. That's kind of fallen down that wall.
So, they would have had big plots of these.
Rows and rows and rows.
This is like a bit risky. I've not gone through here like this before, but I'm going to give it a go. Maybe it's been set up like a trap so that when you walk through it, it'll fall in on you.
In all fairness, the amount of effort
to get all this
someone went through to get it down here.
Yeah, it's crazy, isn't it? Absolutely crazy. All done.
Think of the effort really just to get in here. Do you know what? Let alone the way to get all of this in.
Yeah, mind you, there was a main entrance, but what it is, they closed the gates and they chucked the earth in front of it. So you could get in from street level, but getting in at night past people quietly with vehicles full of stuff to get this lot of stuff in here, it's not easy.
How many tents are there?
I think we said there were about 20.
It just goes on, doesn't it?
Yeah. It does a bit. So you can see what it would have been like when it was set up, look. That's an actual... This is what it looked like.
Just pulled out and ran, wasn't it?
Mm.
So what they do is like illegal migrants working in
the area. Yeah, I think they caught the blokes who were doing it.
This tent's actually not really slashed, is it?
Not much. And all of them are easily repairable.
That'd be some going, isn't it?
There were tens of thousands of pounds worth of this growing liquid.
Yeah.
Because people who came down here were into, you know, they knew their cannabis and stuff, and they were like, look at this, this is worth 250 quid. One of these would be like 250 quid. And they were just lying around, loads of them, loads of them. So I think people have come down here and they've helped themselves.
They estimate that per plant is £1,000.
Yeah.
On resale.
Yeah.
So you're looking here at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 20 in a row.
Mm.
So 20,
and that's 20 times 3, 2, 4, 6.
That's 120,000. See there, per tent.
£120,000 per tent per couple of months.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a million-pound operation. Multi-million-pound operation. This here used to be bigger. It's been knocked around by people, but this is where they lived. So this used to be, you could go in through the front. There was a little door in the front, like a shed, and there was a bed on the left and a bed on the right, table in the middle, and then they used to keep themselves in there and close the door, keep it warm. And the electrics are so ropey, you know, the electrics are in here. I mean, look at all that.
Yeah.
They're running it off low amperage cable, and they're running kilowatts and kilowatts of power through just shit cables. how they didn't, like, blow something up at street level, like, you know, outside, is quite amazing how they managed to get away with it for so long. Maybe what they had to do is, because they kept on blowing fuses, they had to, like, do a bit of light in one, then another,
yeah,
and then alternate it.
Yeah, rotate it, yeah.
Mm.
You know, I see it on police channels, police programs.
It doesn't look like this size, does it?
No. And when you actually get to see it...
Yeah.
So look at the... This wasn't destroyed by the police. This is what was left over.
No.
After those crops were gone...
They threw it.
They threw it and redid it.
And probably, like, in Chilmark, when we went in there, they had rooms that were full from floor to ceiling with the leftovers like this. And you'd think they would take it out and dispose of it, but they were just filling up room after room after room until the whole bunker would have been full, basically, of just rubbish.
I suppose if you when you're in a criminal, find one or two bits in there.
Mm.
When you're still a criminal minded, though, aren't you? You're not really going to tidy up after
yourself. It's so soft as well. I'm surprised.
Did you know in Chilmark they actually had Vietnamese people in there and they lock them in?
Yeah.
So they were, you know, illegally in the country. They sneaked them into the country.
Yeah.
They didn't speak proper English. And when the place was raided, one of them had been working his way, been hacking his way out through an upper... The ladder we went up. He'd done that. He put a ladder up a thing. He'd been sawing through. When the police came in, he shit himself, and he used his escape route, right? And he was the only one who got out. They got what everyone else was in there.
Lucky fucker.
And he got out... But about 2 hours later, the police were driving along, and there was some bloke with no shoes on walking along the road, like a small bloke. And they were like, "You all right?" He's like, "Didn't speak no English." And they're like, "I think you need to come with us, mate."
Fuck. So when he thought he made it, he got found out.
Yeah, but they weren't the growers. The growers was a bloke from Bath who had a band and wasn't all that successful, and he used to sell memorabilia like Batman. And all the films, he'd sell like books,
like comics.
Comic books type thing, you know, and models and things to do with movies. And he had Jimmy Savile's original chair off his thing, you know, with all and all that. Yeah, all the bits used to come out of it.
Okay, you've got a thermostat there. Mm. You've got fan C.
Yeah, so that's a timer up there. That white thing.
Yeah,
timer.
Yeah. Oh yeah, because you've got the little clock there.
Yeah, timer. They had little, you'll see them in a minute, there's little rooms, nursery rooms, which had small lights in them, and they'd grow the small plants up to a certain size before they transfer them into here. So it was a proper little, you know, production line.
I like how they've snipped, the police have snipped all the appliances off.
Yeah, it wouldn't take much to put a plug back on half of them, though.
No. And I suppose these bamboo shoots... You would have had that stuck in the plant.
Yes.
And tied the plant on until it grows up.
That's right. Yeah.
That's amazing, isn't it? Just take that.
Anyone want some cannabis? Still got
cannabis here, mate. Is there some on that plant?
Yeah, there's a cannabis there. See?
There's
sun down here, look.
Oh, that's not worked.
Cannabis leaf.
Negus.
That's can't really smell it now. I think it's been too long. It's been a couple of years now since that's been since this place was busted.
That's mad, isn't it? And then they would have just grinded that shit up and
they would have ground it up into white powder and injected it in their veins. Yes.
When they say drugs is an easy business, I agree with Brandon. This is far too much work for me.
Yeah, definitely.
Mm.
Is that all of them, is it?
Yeah, well, they had their they would have been smoking it in their crack pipes and injecting it up their bottoms as pills.
Drug consumer advice from the secret top.
Yeah.
Who would have thought
that? Yeah, but do it.
Top tip, don't do drugs.
Yeah. You'd have to have like at least 20 of these plants in order to get a good high, I reckon. You know, like smoke 20 of them, you probably get high. But a lot of people, they smoke about 50 plants to get high. So, yeah, you know, it's a lot of green you've got to take into your system. Yeah.
Well,
and it's just cheaper to buy garden peas and eat them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, a lot of people, see, they were, like, growing with the chemicals, and then in the end they found that if they just drank the chemicals, it was get a better high. I think that's actually...
Don't try doing that.
No, but there is some truth to it. There is some truth to it, because they did start using MCAT, which was a substitute for ketamine, and it was just plant fertiliser.
Yeah. Quite a lot of plant fertilisers, actually, isn't it? That's used for...
Yeah, here we go. More rooms, isn't it?
The human race is a very odd species, isn't it?
Yeah. It was like professional operation.
This is bonkers, this is. Imagine the bloke who's running this and got caught, how livid he would be.
Well, he might have been running it on behalf of a bigger operation who'd funded it, you know?
Yeah.
Abroad, they get him out here.
The money that went into just these rooms.
Yeah.
The absolute size of it down here.
Because you imagine, that's going to cost a lot of money, and it's going to be a lot of time to get this set up, but then they're going to leave people running it, but... Okay, they're going to get done, they're going to get probably put inside for 10 years, but when they come out, they've probably got a little nest egg waiting for them from Mr. Big. From Mr. Big, he'll make sure they're all right, like, hopefully. I hope it's that honourable.
You'd hope so, wouldn't you?
You'd like to think so, yeah.
I bet there's a lot of people that used to get a nice...
Well, I was a Game Boy, yeah.
No,
not such luck.
No, that's temperature.
Thermostat, yeah.
Yeah, but a lot of them got a lot of hush money in prison, didn't they? Don't grass me up.
They're probably the biggest.
I bet you they only work with people who've got families, so the families have got to stay behind and get looked after, and if they speak up, your family ain't going to do very well.
Yeah, they just beat the shit out of the family and that.
God, surely you must have smelled that up there. What? On the granddaddy, you must have smelled this.
I don't know. They did have a lot of filters down here. I think a lot of the filters have been taken by people.
I've been doing their rates.
Aye.
Yeah.
That is probably an official weight lifting system.
It's got some weight to it.
Yeah. Oh, you pick on the exercise, mate.
Arnold Schwarzenegger!
So they weren't just crims then, they were actually trying to keep fit as well.
Yeah.
Fill away at that.
No, that's that one.
That's filled with those bees. Do you know when you see on a cartoon when they chuck something like that on the floor?
I think we've been round this way.
Oh, yeah?
Gone around this way.
I don't know which way to go now. No, there's loads of wire. Look at all the wire down here. Looks like copper thieves have probably taken care of the wire situation.
Someone had to make their money back, didn't they?
Yeah, someone's gone and sat down and stripped all of that.
That's mad.
If anyone wants to buy a grow tent, just drop us a private mail.
Yeah.
You have to pay for yourself, but...
Go in cheap.
The would have taken that away, these tents.
Yeah. It's too much time and effort for a minute.
Yeah. They just wanted to show that they've disabled it, and then they've done their job, haven't they? Lazy. Maybe if you put a load of donuts there, like a trail of donuts up to it, though, they'd be in there really quick.
Once
you
finish your shift,
you
can go down
the pub and have a beer.
You can just
play
the brass fingers after that, though.
But they must have been in and out here.
Yeah, it looks good, doesn't it?
That's weird, it just started recording here.
What are these boots?
Somebody burnt something by here. And somebody did talk about, oh, like, it's been set on fire. I think the, you know, idiot.
Mattress, isn't it? That's idiot, a bit.
That's something to do with it, probably. But, yeah, I mean, they said, oh, the whole of Bethel has been burnt down to the ground, so you can't go in there anymore, because it's all been burnt. No, it hasn't. Just a small part of it, like a couple of centimetres of it.
Why does my phone keep doing that? It keeps freezing. That's weird. My torch started flashing randomly and my phone starts freezing.
I'm just trying to make contact with you.
Might be your mum.
As long as I don't owe him any money, it's all good.
Mmm. Okay, a bit of a living area. I think there was a lot of chemicals by here before. That might be full of chemical. There used to be a lot of chemicals down here, but I've not seen so many now. I think that goes down and around the corner, and there's not very much down here. It's like a bit of a dead end.
Do you know how many years this was before it got found out?
No. But
I'm sure it was only 20 minutes down here. I'm sure that's what they said anyway.
All the bottles of water.
Big water tank, isn't it?
The thing is, a lot of explorers know about this tunnel, so I would imagine that the people who were in here doing it would have had to have been shooing people away all the time, and, you know, if they heard anyone coming in, like, fucking giving them aggro. So yeah, there's dead ends, these bits, but we can go over there now and go further down. Ah, Saskia. Saskia is little, so that's not that old, that stuff. And that's all from the people who were here, so that would have been Saskia water. I buy it myself from Lidl's. So, you know, you're talking, you know, probably 5 years, I reckon you'd probably get away with your maximum. And they only got sus because the kids who came down here got beaten up by them and ended up telling their parents where they'd been and who beat them up. If they hadn't have beaten those kids up, if they'd have just given them a bollocking,
it probably would have still been there today.
Yeah. They had to, like, duff them up. A bit smelly in this one. Oh, look at all the water bottles in here, man. They were diverting water in from where we came in, and yeah, that they were diverting water, filling up the pools and then running it down the pipes.
So it's 10 together. They're heavy, aren't they? Mad. All the fans are over there, aren't they?
Little ones, yeah.
But fair play to them. It's far too much effort for me, personally.
Yeah, look at all the shitty electrics here they've done again.
How do you even?
That's mad, isn't it?
I mean, they must have been running an awful lot of power in through probably some not very thick cables. But maybe they doubled and tripled and quadrupled up the cables.
Yeah,
which is even worse.
Mm. I think down here we'll end up at the main entrance in a bit.
So we won't keep them awake.
Yeah.
Red Bulls.
Red Bulls.
Lots of croissants as well.
I'm surprised they had Red Bulls. I would have thought it would have been.
They've got the cheapies though.
Yeah, those gorilla ones from Lidl's. Got some water. This is the old original setup. So you've got water containers there, and I think this is for the showers and bits and bobs. The showers are into the left in a second, in next door. But all their paints.
Yeah,
And there's that's a separated room, so that's a fire protected room for the fuel probably. So we're on the back side of that wall that we couldn't come through from the other room. So this is on the other side of it. Chemical room. No smoking in this room, chemicals.
Do you reckon they reused it as a chemical room?
Probably.
They'd have to re-signpost it then, didn't they?
Mm, look, they've got their own little private cubicles.
Mad, isn't
it? Yeah, protective clothing. So look, that was 1992. Look, Jack Dean Oils.
Oh, yeah?
So I said 1980, 1992. So it might have been going up to the 90s. 30 years ago when they were still operating in this place. Might have been a different company in there by then. And it might not have been the mushroom people anymore. If you want to see what it was like when it was in operation, if you go on YouTube and you type in Bethel Quarry Mushroom Farm or something like that, there's a documentary. I think it's colour. And it shows all the little vehicles coming in out here, all the women who used to work in here. Shows all the stuff, that's the heating thing right next to that room which had the fuel in next door. All the heaters. I think it was like, I think it was Heinz. It was Heinz mushrooms were from here, like.
Looks like quite
a roof,
doesn't it?
Mm. Gets hot really quick, this torch, if you have it on super, super duper.
Yeah.
The scale of it is quite mad.
Yeah, it's bonkers.
Hydrolime. I think that's gone a bit odd.
That would have been a lot of money's worth, sat there.
Really, lime? How much per thing do you reckon?
What, a bag?
I won't even have a guess.
I don't know. 50, 60?
I don't know. Wow.
That's just guessing, Mike.
Yeah, it's a fair old bit of money then.
Just for it.
Each one of those like a £50 note. Yeah. And for some reason this everyone must have been very short that worked in here then.
Yeah, just for that. I'm not tall.
Bang your heads.
Not far off a roof.
Oh, look, there's packing tape over there for some reason. Packing tape.
And even toilet roll in here. Toilet roll.
I bet you there'll be more than that. There'll probably be something down each toilet as well. left behind. See, test the theory. Yes.
First time, yeah, I need a piss.
It's liquidised, but it's definitely dark.
It's liquid ass.
Liquid ass, yeah. It's gone the complete water ass.
Oh my god. Okay, I'm using the tool.
But if you're trying to quit it, if you dip your tip of your finger in it.
Jesus. I tell you though, it's probably a good thing that there's still liquid in there, because otherwise it'll be the smell of the sewers coming up through there.
Yeah.
Look, canna cocoa. Canna cocoa plus. So this is literally grown specifically for cocoa. Cocoa canna. Cannabis.
Yeah.
Cannabis.
Cannabis. Ladies' toilets and washroom.
Inject the cannabis into the German Shepherd.
I'll tell you what, I'll just see what I did to me.
Yeah, because you've risen it.
Yeah.
A little...
Right, are you taking the piss?
That's the main doors.
And that's the boss's transportation, I believe, isn't it?
Mm.
That's what the big man himself drove to work.
Yeah. He was a hobbit, though.
Oh, this is unstable.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah, monkey boat for the monkey.
Mm. Needs a bit of air in the tyres, I think. So, over the top of that door, you can see out. But at the bottom, it's all earth. But if you were to get the pillars out of the way, the doors would open inwards, and you could just dig away at the earth or climb over the top. So it is possible to do it.
Someone's been trying to get these light fittings out, haven't
they? Mm. They might have been. They may be trying to chuck them over the top or something.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you can see the amount of earth behind it, can't you?
Is it earth or concrete? It's gone stiff. I think it's just earth. I think he just filled it with a trough.
See over there, can you?
Mm. But to be fair, it wouldn't take an awful lot to chip through those.
No.
And then the doors would just open inwards. Not that I'm suggesting anyone should do that. All their original wires coming in.
So that's the main road up there, is it?
Yep. There's a pub called the Barge Inn opposite this place.
Oh, right.
Practically directly opposite it.
There's a lot of the workers when it was a mushroom factory. Probably went over there for a pint after on Friday.
Yeah. I wonder whether the landlord does remember seeing him come in.
Sure, he doesn't.
That's funny. That'd be funny if he did.
Please close the door.
Little toilets. I got a feeling they've had parties in here in the past as well, because there's evidence of people spraying up the walls with party stuff, you know?
Yeah.
I did see a bottle of gin back there.
Yeah, and there's a couple of cans of Budweiser lying about.
Hmm.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if you can go through or if you've got to go further up and further to the right, but there are ways through some of these. I think these go off to deads. Because we're basically now, if we go in that direction, we're more out on the street.
Okay, yeah.
And where we came over the canal, and then we took a hard right and went up, and you said, oh, those are nice houses, didn't you?
Yeah.
So those houses would be out that direction. Came over the canal, went up the hill. So...
Put your big lights.
Yeah, 3, 2, 1.
And David.
Thank you.
Oh,
that's a beautiful
island. Mm. We can work our way through. I don't know if you can go in and go left or how further up. I don't think these go anywhere. To go back and around. Not even sure this goes anywhere either.
Does it lock it?
Well, it might do, yeah. There we are, so go up there, down there. This was their rubbish dump.
That's a big room, yeah.
Yeah. There's probably some rats used to like living in this bit, I expect.
I'll bet.
Main drag down to the doors.
Oh Christ, yeah.
Somewhere we cut across to the right in a bit, and then there's the party tunnels. Living It Urban. I know who that is.
Exploring with diggers.
What is it? Exploring with
can't read it.
TV. Use some of the bits and pieces for the original mushrooms. Mushroom boxes. Not sure if we can get it directly through there. I think we're probably best off going around.
That works safe.
Mmm. Might be they blocked something up there. Ah, here we go.
Some fuckers put a sticker in the secret vault on YouTube.
The secret vault is still there, is it? Wow. Wow.
Man's a bloody yobber.
Well, at least he didn't spray paint it. He used a removable sticker.
Oh, no.
It's all the pretty stuff from the
gloves.
Party days. Yeah.
Is that what it's all about, is it?
This is the chemical warfare homage to the rubber glove.
They never knew COVID was coming around the corner and they really needed them.
Mm. Oh, look. Here's another one, look. Secret vault on YouTube. Look, folks, it's a secret vault.
Recognise that name from somewhere. I just don't know why.
Yeah, I must have been down here so many times now, taking people from all over the world. Come and have a look. That's like an amoeba, like an early life form or something. Smells weird in this bit.
Yeah, it does a bit.
Look, somebody's painted the like a shadow. They painted a shadow of weighing scales, look. And on the floor are the scales. You see them?
Oh, yeah.
Just like that's what would have been there. Those two scales would have been on that wall. And hanging in this room. And those are the scales. How weird, isn't it, that somebody's painted it on the wall? Where's the chain then? Where would the chain be hanging down? Chains, I can't see where the chain would have been. Maybe it never did hang here, maybe they made it up.
Yeah, you can't really see it anywhere, can you?
Hmm. Red herring. Yeah, I seem to keep coming the same route, yeah. Just a bit of self-promotion there, folks. Look, you know, secret vault. Don't like, don't subscribe. Don't know who they are.
Section 3.
Fairly clean up here. So you notice they had most of their operation was fairly close to the entrance. So it meant that they could probably hear or detect if people come in. They might have had it alarmed even.
surprise me. Cheeky door ones, that just makes annoying noises.
Well, you get yourself a good quality alarm with a long wire. If somebody comes in, it goes, dick, 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 you can run down and go, excuse me, what are you doing?
Yeah.
And then get them away, and then they'd never know what was further inside.
Yeah.
Maybe it worked for them for a long time.
Yeah.
Skidders. Well, this would be good for my scooter, actually. Get around here, okay, with my scooter. Yeah.
That's great, why not?
I think we could be heading back up and out now. We might have gone through a door like that or something earlier on, I can't remember. If we're not. Yeah, if not, then we'll have to go back in through that little door if this isn't the way out. Get into the next section, I think that's bed. We'll go through that door. I recognise that spray of powder on the floor tells us we're going in the right direction if we go up here. Little clues. And those Harris fence. Yeah.
I'm not bothered about the cat, I'm more bothered about the drink.
Oh, yes.
And food.
You might have gone back to the car.
Yeah, if you're sitting in the car, won't he?
Hopefully.
Yeah.
Hopefully he's physically bummed.
Yeah.
Well, I reckon that yellow line looks like an emergency get you out type of line, doesn't it? It's an emergency escape ladder, 50 metres, like, oh, yeah. Follow the yellow line. It has worn out off the ground. They probably have to repaint it a lot, that little yellow line.
Yeah.
But. Yeah, if you went to every single little corridor left and right, there's a lot of space in here. There we go. There it is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I didn't even see that,
though. Yeah. Yes, easy to miss. So this time, because do you know why I thought I'd set this up? I'd find down. Helps if you press record. What a knob. So I'm gonna get it working this time. We're just going to climb up there for real. Might be times I've done that over the years, just don't press bloody record. Now getting up is a bit of a beast because you do have to stop quite a lot. Because it's quite a climb. So I'm going to have a quick round the corner and then.
Yeah.
get like
a
Batmobile. Let's do it. Let's do it. Yeah, you just have to take your time.
Yeah.
Is the main thing.
I'm just gapping all the things.
Well, I don't know.
Do you want to get to the first level?
Yeah, when you
I don't have to worry, mate, because this shit's going to fall on your head now.
Yeah, look,
so it's entirely up to you. Like, if you can come right behind me if you wish.
You can do that.
Yeah, just get quicker, innit? Yeah, I'll jump it in and sit down there.
Spooky. I'm just going to have... just going to have lots of breaks.
Yeah.
Lots of breaks. Looks bloody hell. Right. Ready for a break yet?
Oh, I already am having one.
Yeah. We passed the first thing, haven't we?
Yep.
There's a light behind us, so you'll lit yourself on it a bit, so watch that one.
Well, that's what I tightened my head on coming down.
Ah.
There's grit splashing me in the face.
Yeah. It's worse when you get down the bottom, though. Lose weight over this weekend, I'll tell you that much.
I'm going to start shooting me, Carol.
Yeah. Wall gets a bit close for you.
Yeah.
Quick break.
Be a bad idea to start doing some pull-ups on your own bit, mate. Oh, these bars are cold, aren't they?
Yeah.
Imagine if there's a fire here, you'd be coming up here and all the fucking smoke would be coming up with you.
Yeah.
You'd probably end up passing out before you even fucking get to the top.
But it depends on how the ventilation was before.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to show the blood get back in my arms a minute. Holding them up, it seems like the blood don't want to go up into them. Again.
Ah, if you're up there, I'm going to be near the top.
Yep. Right, one last break. And No point frigging yourself up.
Yeah.
No, mine are all right. Can't really feel them, to be honest. This is where Dave jumps out at us and bloody we all fall down the ladder. Yeah.
Yeah,
and
I'll knock the cunt square out.
Yeah. No, I'll do it. I just want the cunt. Yeah, coming up's better than going down it.
Yeah, you know what's coming then, don't you?
Yeah, you're not looking down.
I wasn't really looking down, was
I wasn't until obviously when once you're in there, isn't it? And there's nothing to look straight at.
Mm.
I was like, oh shit, I'm out of height.
So there we go, folks. That's it. That's it. One last look down the old chasm. I'll look for the torch, take photos, ready, steady, go.
Shit.
Bad boy. Bad boy. That's a bad boy.
Hi.
See ya. Oh, I've got some drippers on my lens. Give you a bit of emergency power, don't they?
Yeah.
Might be better to flip that up against that. Get it out a bit, yeah. I think he did do that on purpose. It's pretty slimy, isn't it?
Yeah.
I've never slid down there like that before. That's weird.
I ain't got an issue with coal shit. But you put pictures down there, different stories.
Hmm. Right, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. So, catch you later. Don't like, don't subscribe. Don't, I don't know, don't... Do use a condom, though.